Rudolph, join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say,
welcome back to Richmond Tourism Talk. I'm Samantha Burford. Today we're at a very special place. We're at Baldwin Farms, and I'm here with Margie Baldwin. Margie, welcome to our show.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, today, we are very happy to be here, and we want to tell everyone that you guys are more than just pumpkins.
Well, we sure are. Yeah. Most people know us for pumpkins because that seems to be when everybody in Richmond comes out to Baldwin Farm. But actually, we started 25 years ago selling Christmas trees here at the farm, Christmas trees that we grow. And we love having families come every year. They come back, they bring their children, and then a few years later, you never know, those children bring their children. So,
well, and it's a nice Christmas tradition.
It is a good Christmas tradition, and that's the thing that we like to promote. And we really feel that a traditional Christmas begins with a real tree.
You're right. Not so many people do that anymore. There's so many artificial trees out there, and this is something very memorable that people can take with them. And we'll get to the picture taking later. But if people want to come out here, what do? They just come and then take us from there.
Okay. Now, we do have a one-lane road for the most part, and so part of your Christmas tree adventure is coming up our one-lane road, but it's worth the trip once you make it. And when you arrive at the top of the hill, you will greet one of us, or we'll greet you, and give you a map and a saw and a little bit of direction and tell you where to go find your Christmas tree. You'll go take a buggy or a wagon out to the tree field, saw down your Christmas tree, and bring it back, and we'll put it in a stand or drill a hole for the stand.
Okay.
And then we'll help you load it on your car if you'd like, and then we invite you into our little tree shed to warm up by our open fire and share some free hot chocolate and candy canes.
That's great. So don't think that you just show up and you just say, there you go find a tree. It is not like that at all.
Well, you know, it can be if you want it to be like that. And some people already know where they're going, and they just...
The ones that have been here for years and years.
So they know where to go, and they say, oh, well, I got my tree in number 5 last year. That's where I want to go. But we have all the fields numbered. We have about 15 acres of Christmas trees. And so that's about 15,000 trees or so to choose from. And I tell people just go out and choose the tree that speaks to you.
That's right.
And the one that wants to go home with you, that's the one you should choose, within reason. Trees in the field look a lot smaller than they do once you drag them in the house.
So, that is true.
We also have
that's a
trees.
Christmas vacation movie right there.
Yeah, it is. Often. We also have trees with the root ball. If you want to plant your tree after Christmas,
right,
we can do that. We sell wreaths and garland and kissing balls with mistletoe and swags and mailbox covers and lots of other things with evergreen on them. And
right,
we do have some cut trees, too, for people who don't want to or can't cut their
physically
own trees.
Go out into
right,
the field.
Mm-hmm. We okay, have some cut trees. So there's something for everyone here, and we really encourage families to come and make a memory and bring their camera and have a great time and enjoy the beautiful sunshine. And if we have sunshine, sometimes they enjoy beautiful snow.
Well, we've got a beautiful day today. We've been very lucky out here today, and it is beautiful. It smells of Christmas. You're decorating for Christmas as we speak, so
right,
it is beautiful. Now, you do have more than wreaths and trees and things like that. Mm-hmm. We're standing in the house.
This is called Kelly's
house.
Okay. In memory of my kitty, Kelly. we have a lot of things. Most of our products are Kentucky-made products, Kentucky Proud products specifically. I guess what we sell the most of is our salsa. The honey apple salsa is a really
popular
product. And people can make their own Kentucky gift baskets with our products. We have our own local honey. We have Amish jams and sorghum. And we have scented candles and homemade Christmas hair bows and dog treats from a handicap workshop in Maysville. Everything's made in Kentucky, so we're proud of that. And I would encourage people to support their local farm, Baldwin Farm, and to support the other Kentucky-made products by shopping here.
So if people want to come, tell us where you're located. I don't think we've gotten there yet. Mm-hmm. And then we also want to let them know that you've got a website, you've got a Facebook page. That way we'll tell you the hours, but if, in case you didn't write them down or can't remember, right, we can always go to those.
Right. We open for Christmas trees the day after Thanksgiving. Our hours are 11 to 6 every day, so you can come any day of the week, and we stay open through the 22nd of December. A pretty long month there, and we are on Tate's Creek Road, 1113 Tate's Creek Road. We're 3.5 miles from Main Street, easy to find. If you need directions, they are on our website. We also do have a Facebook page, Baldwin Farms. Our website is Baldwin Farms, plural, KY, baldwinfarmsky.com. Have a great website. Be glad for you to visit it, and be sure and come out if you can.
Well, this is very, very special, and I think it's a wonderful and can be a very memorable, is the word I'm trying to say, holiday tradition for your family, especially if you have little ones. Bring the grandparents. The whole family can come, a whole carload.
Mm-hmm. Even the dogs can come.
That'd be great.
And
well,
they do.
We've got plenty here.
Yeah,
so
we do.
Right in.
Only thing, I do ask dogs to be on a leash because we have chickens running around, and sometimes we end up with dead chickens after dogs leave. So we do encourage you to keep them on a leash.
We have rabbits too, right?
We have rabbits, right. And we have lots of little critters. There are goats. There'll be goats down here that the kids can feed, and we have a llama and a milk cow, and lots of little critters running around. So
don't come and just think you're going to be here for 5 minutes and head on out the door. Make a day of it.
And dress for the weather.
And tennis shoes.
Well, or boots. Or yeah, whatever it
don't
takes.
Don't wear your heels.
No. And don't come at dark.
True.
I have had that happen before, too. So, but we have something for everybody, and we hope that lots and lots of people from Richmond and surrounding areas. We are actually the first Christmas tree coming north from the Tennessee line on 75. So
that's
we get
exciting.
Lots of people from down, you know, London, Corbin, all kinds of places.
That's great.
Harrodsburg, Somerset. So.
And then we do, before we go, we want to congratulate you on your big award.
Thank
that
you.
Is very special.
You know, it really was. And the award was from the Bluegrass Energy. It was Madison County Farmer of the Year, which is, you know, enough by itself. But what makes it special to me is that I was the first woman
that is
selected for that particular award. And I just think that is, it makes it really
very
extra special.
Special
for me.
That's right.
Thank you.
Two reasons to be special.
Well,
congratulations. And I think that's it. We'll wrap it up here. And thank you for joining us. This is a very special time and for the holidays here in Madison County. And you guys have something very memorable and very traditional that all these families, whether they're coming from out of town or here in Madison County. So people from Madison County really need to take advantage of this.
They do. And it helps the environment. It helps their local farmers and helps them have a great traditional Christmas.
Well, Margie, thank you for joining us. We appreciate it. We wish you the best this holiday season.
Thank you.
And that's it from Baldwin Farms. I'm Samantha Burford. Thank you for watching Richmond Tourism Talk.